If you're planning to record videos in bright sunlight, then you definitely need to learn how to use a variable ND filter for video. So you might think, what is a variable ND filter? The same way you need sunglasses in bright sunlight, you need variable ND filter for your camera, because cameras cannot really function effectively in very bright sunlight. Some people would recommend that you shoot videos early in the morning or late in the evening when the sun is not so bright. They call it the golden hour. It's a very good time to shoot videos, but if you don't have that flexibility to shoot videos at those times and you just want to shoot video anytime you want, then you need a variable ND filter. A few months ago, I was just walking in the park and I saw a very cute dog running around, and I just picked up my camera and I asked for permission, can I record a video of your dog? And the people that had the dog said yes. And then I started recording, only to discover that the video was extremely bright. I couldn't even see the dog clearly. And I thought to myself, how is this possible? I started recording earlier in the day during the golden hour, but I was out in the park until the sun came out and it was really, really bright. And I was a bit confused that, okay, how do I use my camera in bright sunlight? I started researching filters and stuff like that on YouTube, on Amazon, everywhere. And what I discovered is it's very, very difficult to find a very good variable filter. There's one point that you need to understand. You can buy a variable ND filter, but most of this filter have a particular problem. When you kind of turn the ring and you're darkening the brightness, you get to a stage where like an X sign shows on your filter, then it becomes unusable. So my recommendation to you is to get a variable filter that has hard stops. What this means is, like, when you're turning the ring, it stops and stops on both maximum and minimum. Whereas some variable filters does not have that. They just keep turning round in circles, and that kind of creates that difficulty where an X-shaped shadow shows on your videos. So basically, the same way you record videos indoors in low light is the same way you're going to record videos using a variable ND filter. The only difference is you need to get one variable filter. You don't have to get a variable filter for every lens you own. You get a very large variable filter, and then you get something called a stepping ring. So for example, the variable filter that I use is 82 millimeter thread, and the largest lens I have is 77 millimeter. Then I have another lens, the one I'm shooting with is 72, the Sigma 18-35. So my filter has step up ring. So I have a step up ring that converts 72 straight to 82, and that's what I use when I'm recording videos with my Sigma outside. And then when I'm recording videos using my 17 to 50 millimeter Sigma lens, that is a 77 millimeter thread. So I use that step up ring to kind of adapt the 82 millimeter. So you might be wondering, what variable ND filter should you buy? There are very cheap variable ND filters out there. Some of them are like less than $50 or £50. But it's very important for you to understand that if you invest a lot of money to buy lenses, if you have like 2-3 lenses and the total collection of your lens cost at least maybe $1,500 or more, if you go and get a cheap variable filter, it's going to affect the quality of the videos you produce. So my recommendation is that you get a very solid, not too expensive variable filter, because you only need one for all your lenses. And if you have two camera bodies, then you need two. So, but what I'm trying to say here is the variable ND filter that I got was as a result of buying a lot of filters and realizing that the quality wasn't up to scratch. This video is not sponsored in any way. It's just my recommendation to you on how to use a variable ND filter for video. Again, you just put on your filter onto your lens, and then you record. But if you're looking to set like white balance and stuff like that, you want to make sure that you increase the aperture very, very high so you can then set the white balance. After you've set the white balance, then you can then put your variable ND filter on it and then start recording. Be careful not to set your white balance before you put your variable ND filter on. I'm going to release some more videos about how to set white balance, camera setting and stuff like that, because that is the best way for you to create good videos. If you can nail your white balance, then whatever video you create will be top quality. I'm a Canon shooter. I'm not endorsed by them or sponsored by them, but the best picture quality, you can achieve that in camera using a variable filter outdoor if you're able to nail down your white balance. You can use an app, for example, to kind of get the white balance. I'm going to leave links in the description about an app that I use that helps me understand the color temperature before I kind of set it within my camera. So if you have any question concerning variable ND filter, video production, or any of those stuff, post your question in the comment section. I'll do my best to answer them. And if you're looking to create a video marketing strategy as part of your content marketing strategy, or you're looking to create videos for your YouTube channel and you need an external resource to help you, contact me, click like, subscribe to my channel, and I'll see you in the next one. Thank you.